stampa.
Is the Miss Photogenic Award. This is a social media award where the ladies had taken photos at her first practice, and you guys liked the picture of the lady that you thought was most photogenic. This award goes to Miss Jacksonville!
So right now, ladies and gentlemen, we're just waiting for the tabulation of the judges, but I do have already, finally, who is Miss Foundation. Now, if you don't know who is going to be the Miss Foundation, her title is one of the best because of the function and the event we're having here. She is the lady who raised the most funds for Batay Bata 163. She sold so much raffles, collected donations, and everything goes for Batay Bata. So she's also second to the title of Miss Philippines Earth Fiesta Musa Florida 2017. So let's give a round of applause to this lovely lady. Before we find out this year's winner, let's take a good look at the message of last year's winner through the screen, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies, you can turn around if you want.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage my friend, Miss Foundation 2016, Miss Caitlin Suico! Here we go. Miss Foundation 2017, let's say it together, is Miss Tallahassee!
Raising $3,625 for Batay Bata. Our Miss Foundation 2017 is Miss Lauren Mosley representing Tallahassee. She and her family and friends raised $3,625 for Batay Bata. All these lovely ladies have also contributed, but of course the Miss Foundation goes to the highest solicitation and sales of tickets.
Give it up one more time for Fiesta Musa Florida Miss Foundation 2017.
Now we've reached a turning point this evening. It's time to find out our top five. Are you all excited?
Yes.
Are you ready to find out our top five?
Yes.
In my hand is the card with the names of our five finalists.
Now ladies, I have to say that you all did amazing today. And you should all be proud of yourselves because I, Lloyd, your family and your friends are very proud of you. Right, audience?
Yes.
But unfortunately, we can only choose five of you to go on to the final round of the competition. So on behalf of Lloyd, Tito Joey and myself, and everyone associated in this event, thank you and congratulations.
Yuzel, let's not keep the suspense any longer. Ladies and gentlemen, here are the top five in random order. First in the final five is Miss West Palm Beach. May I ask our top five to please go to the back of the stage? Step back, ladies, as we get ready for our Q&A. Now, for the last part of our competition, the judges' questions. Here is how it works. Each of our candidates will pick a judge's name from the bowl. That judge they choose will ask them a question.
What?
And they will have 30 seconds to answer the question from that judge.
What?
All of the questions are environmentally themed. So ladies, take a deep breath, all right? And remember, we are all rooting for you. Right, audience? We are all rooting for them. Can I have the fishbowl, please?
Ooh.
And may I have a mic for our judges?
Mr. Ginoo 27.
Oh, we have a mic, sorry. We have a mic. All right. May we ask Mr. Florida, if you also Mr. Florida, step a little bit. All right. May we call on Ms. Jacksonville?
Ms. Jacksonville, your question will be coming from judge number one, Dr. Yim Chan.
Hello, Ms. Jacksonville. This is a long question, so I can repeat it if you need to. The question is, the United States pulled out of the Paris Climate Accord back in June. Yet some of the states and cities in the United States have decided to continue to remain committed to its goals. What are your thoughts about this?
The United States is a collection of many different types of states, of course, but each state has its own unique properties. I believe that since each one has its own government, each one should be able to function in its own manner. Thank you very much. you so much, Miss Jacksonville.
Up next, we have Miss Naples, Victoria Willis. Please choose a judge's name from the bowl. And you have chosen Judge Rosary Escaño.
Good evening, Miss Naples. Okay, my question for you is, what do you think is the best way to teach the young generation about protecting the environment?
Well, I believe teaching the young generation about the environment starts by first informing them what we need to fix most, which could be cleaning out our water system and even taking shorter showers at home, no bathing very long, and everything begins from there, and we can grow and eventually take larger steps into cleaning up this earth. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Naples.
Let's welcome up Miss Atlantic Beach.
Lindsay Fuchs.
Your question will come from judge number three, Dr. Cynthia Crawford.
Hello, Lindsay. Miss Atlantic. If you were tasked to create an environmental program or project, what would it be?
Well, I would like to help with saving the animals and all the aquatic animals, as well as try and reduce as much pollution as possible, so that our earth will continue to grow and thrive. Thank you.
Thank you, Miss Atlantic Beach.
Up next, we have Miss Tampa, Christina Benedetti. Please choose a judge's name from the bowl. And she has chosen judge number two, Alexis Nevalga.
Hi, Miss Tampa. So my question for you is, the slogan of Miss Earth is beauties for a cause. How do you think beauty pageants can have a positive impact to the cause of protecting the environment?
Thank you. I believe that beauty pageants are a great way to spread the cause of protecting the environment, because through the entertainment industry, many people watch it. If beauty pageant contestants are able to spread the awareness of the environment and saving Mother Earth, I believe that many people will be aware of the ways that we can protect it. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Tampa.
Our last candidate, Ms. West Palm Beach, come front and ask the question.
I think we know who it is.
No, we don't. Your question will come from judge number five, Jericho Rosales.
Oh my God.
Hello.
Hi.
I'm very nervous. So you should be okay. All right, hi, good evening, Miss Palm Beach. Here's your question. If you were, like tonight, I have a pre-question for you. Have you ever been to the Philippines?
I have not.
You have not? If you were to become the president of the Philippines, what environmental issue would you focus on?
The Philippines being a country of thousands of islands, I would first and foremost focus on the ocean and all its creatures. With pollution in the environment today, it is of the utmost importance that we focus on saving the beautiful creatures that populate our planet. Thank you.
Thank you, Miss West Palm Beach. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes our competition for Miss Philippines Third Florida 2017. A round of applause for our candidates. And now, but the moment has come for our judges to make their final decision. As each of our candidates steps forward, the judges will give them a ranking of 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. As they vote for her to be the fourth runner-up, third runner-up, second runner-up, first runner-up, and the new Miss Philippines Earth Florida 2017. Remember, the vote is based on their overall impression of the candidates today, in addition to their answer to the final question. So judges, you are voting on who you feel will be the best Miss Philippines Earth Florida 2017. Let's begin the votes with Miss Jacksonville.
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, baby, when I turn it on. All through my city.
Let's bring flowers. It's Victoria Willis, Miss Naples.
I feel it when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket. That's all I want.
Atlantic Beach, Lindsay Phipps. So as we tally the scores, Tita Joey and Yuzel will spend just a few minutes with our candidates as we give their judges some time to finish their tally. Okay? We'll be right back.
Okay.
There you go, guys.
Ooh, I get to ask questions. I love this.
We'll go from the center.
Hi, Lindsay. How are you feeling tonight?
Honest, I'm pretty nervous.
So what is something you would do to calm your nerves in a situation like this?
Well, I'm trying to take deep breaths and smile. And my great friends are right behind there cheering me on.
That support system. Good job, everybody.
Wow. Ladies, this is it. One of these lovely ladies we will be seeing in Manila in June 2018. And guess what? I will be there again. I'll be seeing you. We will be going together with Risa and Fernando. So I'm as excited as you are. Who is it gonna be? What happened from what I learned from Alexis, you will have to check in something like 2 weeks before, 3 weeks before, Alexis. And then you go, you plant trees, you visit recycling systems in the Philippines, You go to all over the islands, nice, no? And then finally, like 5 days before the pageant, you are locked up in the hotel. No more going out, no more partying, all rehearsal for the final pageant. And the final pageant this year was fabulous. You should have seen it, Uriel. You know what, they came in the opening, all the contestants were wearing Wonder Woman inspiration outfits that they chose themselves. So 57 ladies coming out as Darna, Valentina, Wonder Woman. It was spectacular, beautiful, beautiful.